edition of the Brain Ladle Trivia Podcast. I am your MC, Davo. With me today, we have Kels.
Hello there.
We have Twi.
It's-a me.
Yes. We have Andy.
Hello, Ladle Brainers.
We have the Sensei, Neil.
Hey, everybody.
And making her triumphant return, we have Bettina.
Hi, everybody.
Hello.
Hello. How are y'all today?
Good.
Good.
Very good.
Good.
Yeah.
Oh, Neil. Freewheeling Aquarius Neil. When will you ever learn?
I'm a Libra.
Okay, that makes sense.
You felt like a Libra.
Yeah, really did.
Balance in all things.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So I think what we're going to do today is play a game of trivia. And the way it's going to work is we're going to have a theme. Each category pertains to that theme somehow. And each category has four questions worth 10 points each. And then there's going to be a final, which is worth up to 100 points. And today's questions are coming from Ms. Bettina.
Yay!
Yay! So there'll be mercy.
Well, yeah. To this quiz, we are going to set sail. And as most of you know, I live at the beach in beautiful North Carolina and love the water.
Kakalaka.
Yeah, this is a nautical themed quiz. Yes. And we do, I do include like a river here and there in some of my questions, but it is summer and it is time to hit the water. And so I love to dedicate my quiz. And of course, I'm going to dedicate this to our favorite captain, Captain Horatio Magellan Crunch.
Yes.
And
yes.
His heroic Why? Work patrolling
the
sea of Nova.
Getting the accolades he most richly Why? Deserves, Kels.
Set up, man.
He's not real.
He is so.
If he didn't exist on a box, you wouldn't know who the hell he was.
Have you seen the Hamburglar on the streets lately? No. You know why? Because Captain Crunch went out and got him and put him in jail. Yeah. Keeping our streets safe.
Let me see if I get this straight.
Streets.
In your world, Captain Crunch is real, but LB5K yes. is not.
Yeah.
LB5K is something we invented. Captain Crunch comes from God. Just like Colonel Sanders and Gravy. They're God's work.
You know, I looked up Captain Crunch and I didn't realize he was patrolling the shores of Ohio. That kind of downplays his heroism a little bit.
Wait, what?
The Great Lakes? The Great Lakes?
Yeah, he patrols the Sea of Milk off the shores of Ohio. I thought I was the last person to know that.
In retirement.
Yeah, in retirement.
Nope, don't dress it up. This is your hero.
He did two tours in Nam. I want to clarify, that's Nam as a nom nom nom, not the Vietnam.
Oh my gosh.
Nom nom nom.
I'm going to mute already. Hold on.
Yeah, I would drink too after that.
That was brilliant.
So for anybody who didn't hear our pre-show banter, Bettina muting means she's getting some booze.
Oh no.
It's the only way I can come on.
Wait, you can't enjoy our company sober?
Well, Davo's been using muscle relaxants apparently, so.
That's why I tried to.
Really loosens up the swearing with him, by the way. Speaking of our production meeting.
Davo's going to need a minute. I know this laugh.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, this is bad, y'all. Oh, no.
It's going to be a long night, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I sent Twi a message just warning her of what it's like when I record.
Oh, man.
She pre-apologized.
I pre-apologized, right,
Wow.
Twi?
Yeah. All good.
We're
all good.
I might say some regrettable things.
Wait, regrettable for you or for us?
Which they never edit out.
I have to apologize weekly to Sensei formally for not being good enough.
nom 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 joke. Well, that went you forever.
Tell you, Dave was not okay. He said, "I'm all right. I'm back." No, you're not
a liar. He wasn't back yet.
Oh, boy. Get your affairs in order, sir. You're a professional.
I am. Okay. All right. I just can't think of it anymore.
Yep, struggle.
It's real. It's the killing joke. Yeah. I've launched the killing joke.
Okay, I'm back. I'm ready to focus.
Stop. Think about baseball. Think about baseball.
Stop saying it until it's real.
Fake it till you make it, buddy. Here we go.
All right, you ready to hear category one?
Yes, please.
Yes.
All right. Category one is on seafarers,
aka seamen.
Wow, children! Right now.
Going after all the low hanging fruit tonight.
Well, it's so ripe. You just gotta pick it.
Yeah.
We can cut that out.
No, we can't. I'm sweating.
You're not wrong, Neil.
Yeah, I mean seamen.
Woo. All right, question one.
Well, we're all ready to question one.
Yes.
Already. We made it.
Okay. Question one. What is the name for the longboat that the Vikings used, which typically featured a carved dragon head? This boat shares its name with a fragrance for men introduced by Guy LaRoche in 1972.
Oh, they call their boats high karate.
Yeah, you beat me to it. I was right there.
I even wrote in parentheses, tell Andy it's not high karate.
Yeah. You can tell me, but I am not believing.
You know, I looked that up and I thought it was like high exclamation.
No.
Karate.
Me too. Andy too.
It's it even more so racist sense. Than that. It's even more
racist. It really is. I'm locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Okay. All right. Kells, what do you got?
Frigate.
Oh, slow clap.
Thank you.
Twy?
Dragon ship.
There you go.
Andy?
Chevy Nova? Were they Chevys?
Wouldn't it be a Saab?
I should know with a Saab. You're right.
It's so stupid, but it's so funny.
What is a Viking launcher called? Purple.
Dave, what do you got?
Dragon ship.
A doctor has recommended that you have a sleep.
That's not right, man.
I'm so sorry. I thought this might be an easy one. This is Jakar.
Oh. Jakar, no. Oh.
I didn't know that.
Oh. Jakar.
Yeah. Or Draker Nor, if you don't know how to say it.
Give me some of that Draker Nor. I smell so sweet when I wear it.
So Jakar came out in 1972, and then the Jakar Noir came out in 1982. All right, question two. In 1937, Crystal City, Texas, erected a statue of a sailor who helped the residents avoid financial ruin during the Great Depression. This sailor promoted an iron-rich product that Crystal City is known for producing. Who is this sailor? And I have an easy mode.
Okay, let's go straight to it. I'd love that easy mode.
I don't want you to have to repeat all of that. But I was checking out at various points.
I just figured it out. Mm-hmm. But I'll, can I unlock for an easy mode?
You can uneasy mode. Yeah, you can uneasy mode.
I want to.
What do you mean you can uneasy mode?
Why can't you? Uneasy
mode. I'm locked in.
Iron. Locked in.
The easy mode is this sailor was played by Robin Williams in a 1980 movie.
All right,
Twy.
Popeye.
Andy.
Former first mate and close and dear friend of Captain Crunch, Popeye the Sailor Man.
I don't think any of that's true.
Yeah, because the first mate will get a cartoon before the captain.
Dave-o?
Well, sorry. I was sailing the seas of milk. Sorry. Popeye. Nom.
Such an easy mark at this point.
I know. I felt bad for doing it. As soon as I did, I felt bad.
Okay. I got a mute. Oh, boy.
I'm going to have to Google this joke. I don't think I get it.
It's not worth it. Google is so dumb. It's just so funny.
It's too stupid.
That's it? That's
not even funny.
And, no, of course what not. And that, yeah, and
God. That's what the heck is wrong with you, Dave-o?
Kells, I'm sorry.
Popeye.
It is Popeye, yes.
Yay.
And you know what? If you have chance, you can go online to the Crystal City website, and it's so funny. They're like, about the statue, and it tells you where it is, and it's like, it's behind a police station, and then it says, and it's hard to see, and then in parentheses, and it says, especially at night. Like,
I love them already.
Yeah. The parentheses was added after the fourth nightly accident.
I know. The fourth tourist came at night and couldn't find it. It's behind the police station. Oh, I gotcha. All right. Question three. What ship under the command of Captain Jonas Grumby and his trusty mate John Gilligan set out with 7 passengers on board for a 3-hour tour in September of 1966? 5 bonus points if you can tell me what city they departed from.
Ooh, I do not know that.
Oh. Locked in with the city too. I got it.
Really?
It was Cleveland.
Sailing the seas of milk.
I'm locked in.
Locked in?
I'm locked in.
All right, Dave-o.
The Minnow, the SS Minnow, and I said San Diego.
And Kells?
SS Minnow, Fort Lauderdale.
Twy?
SS Minnow, Los Angeles.
Did Andy. None of you...
I didn't watch the show. I watched the beginning.
Because the only question... So it's the Minnow, but the only question is, what city in Hawaii? They departed Hawaii.
Is it Hawaii? Oh.
Hawaii is not a city.
Right. That's what I said. Which city in... I'm pretty sure it's Honolulu.
It was Honolulu, yes. It was SS Minnow and Honolulu.
Yeah.
Well,
that makes a lot more sense that they would be lost. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you just set sail for 3 hours off the coast to California, they might find you.
Big place, you know.
Fair.
Oh, all this time they were just on Catalina.
Yeah.
Who knew?
The SS Minnow was actually not a steamship, which SS stands for steamship. But they just threw it in there to make it sound like it was an impressive boat. Yeah.
Did not know that. Did not put that together. That's interesting. Yeah.
See, I should have used that for a question, but I didn't. Just put that as a trivia nugget.
No.
Okay, question 4. What 2012 film has a main character named Richard Parker? Inspiration for this character's name has 3 possible origins. 1 from an Edgar Allan Poe story and 2 from real shipwrecks involving... Richard Parker's. Locked what was this film? And I have an easy mode. I apologize. I have an easy mode.
Okay. Cool.
Locked in?
Richard Parker. 2012. I'll take the easy mode. Why not?
Okay.
Spider-Man's uncle.
So is everyone locked in? And Dave-o needs the easy mode?
Sure.
Okay. The easy mode is the character Richard Parker was a tiger.
Oh. Okay, locked in.
Well, that narrows it down, doesn't it?
The Frosted Flakes story.
It's either Tony or this guy.
All right, Andy.
I love the movie, but it was one of the greatest books I've ever, ever read. Life of Pi.
Hey, Devo?
Life of Pi.
Kels?
Life of Pi.
And Toy?
Life of Pi.
Yep, it's Life of Pi.
All right, at the end of category one, Devo has 25. Mm-hmm. Kels and Twy are tied at 30, and Andy has 35.
All right.
All right, so the second category is potpourri, but it has a mystery twist. So all these questions, answers have something in common, like you would have in a mystery-themed game. So once you know what these answers have in common, send a message to Neil, and whoever gets it first will get 5 bonus points. Oh,
I have to open up the private Slack then, and it's just a history of every wrong answer.
a vast history of failure. Just,
and the gloaty, I mean, he can gloat by just saying no. I don't know how he does it. He just types back, no, but it makes me feel bad every damn time.
Oh, Neil, this is hilarious. The Queen, I just scrolled up, and the Queen episode, when I guessed Queen and you said yes, I didn't put it together until just now. Yes, Queen. I was like, Neil just feeling sassy today, but no, it makes sense.
That was like 5 months ago.
So long
ago. That is a slow burn.
Oh, that makes oh, that's beautiful.
You ready for question one?
Yes.
Let's do it.
Oh, okay. All right. What folk singer and civil rights advocate recorded the song Day-O in 1955? The song was first sung by Jamaican dock workers as they loaded produce on ships at night to avoid the heat. And I just need the singer's last name.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Okay. Kels?
Belafonte.
Twy?
Belafonte.
Andy?
Belafonte.
Devo?
Belafonte.
Correct. It's Belafonte, or Harry Belafonte. Correct. In question number two, in the Divine Comedy, what poem details a voyage through the different levels of hell? In the fifth circle, the narrator Dante sees the wrathful fighting each other on the shores of the River Styx.
Locked in?
Andy. Oh, no. Oh, no.
It's Constantine.
No, don't. No, it's not.
Keanu Reeves was great in that movie.
Locked in, I guess. Yeah.
He didn't even say whoa.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Oh, okay, good. Twy?
Inferno?
Andy?
Inferno?
Devo?
Inferno.
Kels?
Inferno.
It is the Inferno. That's correct. All right. Question three. What Greek god is depicted riding a chariot pulled by a team of 2 or 4 fish-tailed seahorses? And 5 bonus points if you can tell me the name of these horses, which is also an area found in your brain.
Locked in.
Oh, locked in.
I don't know. I know. Locked in.
Locked in.
All right. Andy, what you got?
I said Poseidon and the cerebellum. I have no idea. The only brain part I could come up with.
Yeah. Poseidon and hippocampus.
Hmm. Kels?
Poseidon, hippocampus.
But they're seahorses, not hippos.
What is Andy?
Just talk, Kels.
Okay, you're right. You don't have to fight every battle, Neil. You are correct.
You know what? That's a good whisper clue next time. If you need something. Yeah. Candy.
Yeah.
Hippos are... I'm sorry, Twy.
Poseidon and hippocampus.
Poseidon and hippocampus. I'm sorry, I couldn't mimic you.
No, I'm gonna try your approach next time. Thank you.
Andy, hippocampus. Yeah. Sorry, Andy.
Okay.
Huh.
I'm just saying, I know the difference between a hippo and a seahorse.
Oh, but you don't. But you don't.
Okay, last question. What flag, when hoisted by pirates, would strike fear in the hearts of most sailors? The name for the flag may come from the roguish, undisciplined behavior characteristic of pirates.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Okay. Devo, what do you got?
The Jolly Roger.
Kels?
Jolly Roger.
Yar.
Why?
Jolly Roger.
Yar. Wow.
The Jolly Roger.
Yahar!
That's awesome.
No, no, it's not. You're just getting him more excited.
So, Neil, did anybody guess the theme?
Well, I got guesses from two people. They were both correct, more or less. So I'm going to give the points to Devo because he guessed sooner. He said shipwreck movies, but the correct answer is they're all movie ships.
Yes.
So,
So the Belafonte was the
Steve Zissou
in the Life Aquatic.
Oh, shoot.
And Inferno was Goonies. And Poseidon was Poseidon Adventure Adventure.
Right.
And then Jolly Roger was in Peter Pan and Hook. Yeah. Good job, Devo.
So Twi also guessed correctly, but she guessed later.
There can be only one winner, Yar. Oh, great.
I feel like a winner.
Do you know right now we're all winners because with that bonus point from Devo, everybody has 75 points.
Whoa, that's crazy.
Woo. I'm glad to join the club.
All right. So the third category is music.
Oh, God bless you. Yes.
So much for the time.
What is the name for a sailboat that typically has one mast and two sails? A disastrous voyage involving this vessel is detailed in a Bahamian folk song that was later a hit by the Beach Boys.
Locked in.
What? What?
No easy mode for this one.
No.
Because it's so easy.
Okay. You can walk in place. Beach Boy song.
Little Deuce Coupe.
No.
This is probably my favorite Beach Boy song.
Really?
Yeah. Sorry.
Don't apologize for your own personal taste. No,
you're not. Andy's just a snob.
I'm not being a snob. That's a deep cut in a way. I mean, not a lot of people would say it's their first favorite Beach Boy song. I feel like you've all heard this song.
I've heard it.
Every hear it time you say that. Bell? It's a guarantee that one of us hasn't.
Really?
Is it Barbara Ann?
I can make up an easy mode if you would like me to.
I don't know.
You know what? They're being snotty. No. Don't you throw them a life preserver. You told them not to dive out into the water.
Hey, I wasn't being snotty. I was just laughing. Don't punish you because of the rest of the class.
You're right. That's true. That's fair. That's legit.
Solidarity, Twi. He's the one being a snob. Solidarity.
See, if this was a science question and everybody got it and Andy didn't, you would want an easy mode. Right, Andy?
I'm locked in. I'm just going to throw a guess out there.
I'm locked in, too.
I can make up an easy mode. It's up to you guys. No?
No, we're fine. That's okay. We'll make up an easy mode for this one, we'll never hear the end of it. And if Andy loses by, like, 5 points, it's going to be the end of the show. So we like
having you on. Yeah, I'll never be back. Oh, sorry. Okay. Kels, what do you got?
Bob, bobbering.
Twy.
Kokomo.
Yeah.
And Andy.
The sloop John B.
Davo.
What?
I said a schooner.
A schooner.
And it is a sloop, and the song is Sloop John B. Yes.
John B is a singer.
Very much so.
It's also a sloop.
It's on the John B, I know.
Right.
I know none of the component parts of this at all. So
you'd recognize the chorus if you heard it where they're singing, I want to go home. Please let me go home.
Oh.
Nope.
Is that how it goes?
No. No.
All right. No. Well, Andy's saying.
Wow.
Twy's dropping like sorry, four Andy. Octaves. No. No.
Okay. Question number two. What musical, based on a book by Edna Ferber, takes place on the Cotton Blossom, a floating theater that travels along the Mississippi River? Notable songs include Old Man River, which Paul Robeson would sing in the film adaptation.
Old Man River.
You didn't finish the sentence. Wow.
Sorry. That just, it hit me so hard. I'm sorry.
I'm locked in.
I think Dave-O ruined that song for me. I don't think I can ever hear locked that song in. Again in the same way.
It needed ruining?
just saying. It's a different song.
I liked
now.
It. That's the only part of the song I know is the title.
That's the only part anybody knows.
Twy?
Showboat?
Andy?
Showboat.
Davo?
Showboat.
Kels.
Now when I say who was the master, you say showboat.
Showboat. Good job. Okay. What British actor and singer who shared his name with a mythical pirate made his first US TV appearance on the Ed Sullivan Show the same day as the Beatles? He would later be in a TV series, which critics dubbed a Beatles Meets America sitcom.
Locked in.
Locked in. I reject the entire premise.
I'm going to give you easy mode, Twy. Have you ever seen any other Brady Bunch movies?
Yeah.
This person performed at Marsha and Greg's high school. I guess all the kids that were in high school went to the same high school. So went to the kids' high school. He performed there.
Huh. I have no clue. It was Ray Guy. Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Yeah, I'm punting.
All right, Andy.
Davy Jones of the Monkees.
Oh.
Davy Jones of the Locker.
Wow.
Okay, Kels?
Davy Jones.
And Twy.
Now Ray Guy comes in for his first punt of the day. Kick is away. There's a high, twisting, hang time spiral.
Question four. What mostly instrumental song by the Safaris has been used in over 20 films and TV productions? The witchy laughter in the song was a joke, but unedited because nobody thought the single would sell. And 5 bonus points if you can tell me who performed the song at Woodstock.
Ooh. Wait, Woodstock? I was meaning to write it down, but... locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Okay. Davo?
Wipeout.
Kels?
Wipeout, and I guessed Jefferson Airplane.
Oh.
Oh, Davo, did you have a guess? I'm sorry.
Heck to the no.
Twy?
Witch Doctor.
And do you have a guess?
No.
Okay. Andy?
Wipeout, and I don't specifically know who did it Woodstock, but logically it almost have to be Sha Na Na Na.
Oh.
Wait.
Oh man.
I'll give it to you.
Okay.
Well, that was one too many knots.
Oh, I added an extra knot. That's funny. I counted on my favorite. You know why? I was playing around with the idea of saying Sean nom 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 nom, but I just thought it was. I didn't want to have to reset Davo.
I loved Sean nom 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 nom.
All right, so at the end of category three, Twy has 85, Kells and Devo 105, and Andy 120.
All right. Okay.
Hey, cleaned up in the music round.
Shocker. Getting salty.
Well, Devo, I think category four is going to be your wheelhouse.
Oh.
Oh, man.
So category four is on lighthouses.
Oh, boy.
Really?
Oh, boy.
I mean, did I actually get your hopes up there, Dino?
I fall for it. I'm a trusting soul.
He really enjoys that.
I fell for that, too. I was like, oh, good. I wrote something for Devo.
I know Devo one is lighthouse. Secret lighthouse fan.
I love Devo's lighthouses.
Devo's really into lighthouses.
I am.
The movie Lighthouse to him is kind of a feel-good movie.
It felt great. Wonderful film.
It is a great film.
But wonderful.
Dark.
Mm-hmm. So maybe this will make it easier because you can only guess. There's only 50 guesses. Okay.
Woot. So
what? What kind of diabolical thing is this?
I said that wrong.
It's supposed to be fun. Okay.
It's a multiple choice with 50 answers. With 50 optional answers. Kind of.
What the hell? So I'm guessing that she's going to name a lighthouse and you have to say what state it's in.
Yes.
Oh,
very good. There you go.
Fantastic.
Well, we know about the famous lighthouses of Wyoming.
There's, you know.
And to narrow it down, these are all on the East Coast.
Okay.
Well, that's easier.
All right.
Question one. This might be it.
Okay.
All right. The Cape Hatteras Lighthouse is the tallest lighthouse in the United States and oversees the area known as the Graveyard of the Atlantic. The pirate Blackbeard, who terrorized this area, would die nearby in Ocracoke in 1718.
Locked in.
Start with Kels.
North Carolina.
Twy.
North Carolina.
Andy.
Solely using states Devo has lived in, North Carolina.
Exactly.
Devo?
North Carolina.
Okay, that's negative 10. Sorry. Yeah. Thank you.
But ladies and gentlemen, this is exciting. I just confirmed that is the 150th time he's used that joke. It's the 150th anniversary, everybody.
Yay.
Congratulations. They said it couldn't be done.
Or, I take that back.
They said it shouldn't be done. But we did it. And there you go.
You must have really restrained yourself because I've been on like 7 times, I think. And I'm from North Carolina. So you haven't said it at all to me.
Nope.
No, he said it earlier today. Like,
tonight. Yeah, this is the second time today.
Oh, well, yeah, that was 149.
And then, I guess I wasn't listening.
That happens a lot to me.
Sorry. Okay, question two. The Marshall Point Lighthouse on Penobscot Bay was built in the 19th century to guide ships exporting this state's resources, such as shellfish, which is still prized today. This lighthouse makes an appearance in the film Forrest Gump.
I'm locked in.
Well, I've seen it.
Locked in.
Twy?
Maine?
Andy?
Maryland?
Devo?
Maine.
Kells?
Maine.
How did everybody know that was Maine?
Because the shellfish is lobster.
She said lobster, not crab.
I think a shellfish. Oh, okay.
And Penobscot Bay was where George Bush Sr. had his vacation home.
Oh.
So he would go to Penobscot for.
That's right. There it is. Okay.
And I put a note. Question three. Point Lookout Lighthouse is located on the Chesapeake Bay and is a go-to for paranormal investigators. In 1863, Camp Hoffman, a prison for Confederate soldiers, was built nearby in Point Lookout Park. Multiple witnesses state they have seen apparitions of some of the 50,000 soldiers who came here during the war.
I'm locked in. I got like three guesses.
Right.
You can only guess once, though.
Dang it.
Parentheticals. No,
we have parentheticals. Those are allowed.
Locked in.
If it makes you feel better.
I'm locked in.
Okay, Andy.
Chesapeake is in Maryland. Maryland.
Avo.
Or Virginia.
No.
Kells?
I said Virginia too.
Twy?
Maryland.
It is Maryland.
Oh.
Maryland.
I was nervous.
Because, I mean, I guess, well, you're a teacher. They wouldn't have a prison for Confederate soldiers in Virginia, right?
In Virginia, no.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It would be in Maryland. Yeah, that's correct. Sullivan's Island Lighthouse is located on one of the 35 barrier islands in this state. This lighthouse's unique triangular shape was designed to withstand hurricane winds, which was tested when Hurricane Hugo made landfall here on September 22nd, 1989.
Locked in.
So this one lighthouse was designed for hurricanes, and the rest, you're on your own.
This triangular shape.
I got one design in me. The rest, round, I think you're screwed.
I'm locked in with it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Why was that the laugh from He-Man there for a minute?
Yeah.
I'm locked in.
Locked in, He-Man.
I am locked in.
Okay. Davo.
South Carolina.
Kells.
South Carolina.
Twy.
South Carolina.
Andy.
I don't want to say.
Did you name something on the West Coast?
No. I said Georgia, but for some reason I thought the Barry Islands were Georgia.
Actually, South Carolina is the state, I believe, is the second.
What's that?
Yeah.
You want to mute again so you can get some more wine in you?
Take a swig.
I think Florida has the most barrier islands and South Carolina has the second.
Okay.
I don't know what I'm trying to say. I might be wrong on the first.
It's always fun to throw out facts if you don't really know what you're talking about. Nobody's ever going to check. Don't worry about it.
That could be our corporate slogan.
This may be right.
I didn't really research this quiz. I just kind of made shit up.
I did. I noticed just the second, though, but not the first. But I couldn't remember what the first was.
I think we just found our credo.
It's okay if you're wrong. No, it's the state with the second most barrier islands. Does that make sense? Maybe.
It's fine.
Okay.
So at the end of category four, Twy has 125, Dave O'Kell's 135. And Andy 140.
And Bettina's on her second bottle.
Her $2 wine.
I haven't even drank most of it. This is just me.
I'm just letting you breathe.
I know. It's terrible wine. Okay. First, you know, and I told Neil this, and I don't know if this makes any of y'all feel better, but I never drink unless I'm on this show. So.
Wow.
That doesn't make us feel better.
I drink because of the show.
I'm honored. She trying to get sauced up to come play with us.
Gotta make a good impression. All right, category five is first in films.
Okay.
In 1906, Robert Bonine, a cinematographer hired by Thomas Edison, shot a documentary of life in the Polynesian Islands. He was the first to film the locals engaging in he'e-nalu, a recreational activity that can be traced back to 12th century cave paintings. What is he'e-nalu?
Well, don't everybody lock in at once.
All right, I'm locked in.
Oh, I'm locking in.
Locked in?
Locked in?
Okay. Kells?
I said surfing.
Twy?
Rock art?
Andy?
Lawn darts. That's why so few people from that tribe survived today. Very dangerous game. Very dangerous.
Davo.
Is it a dance?
It is surfing.
Wow.
Surfing's a good guess. It was a good guess. It was much better than
like a haka, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Which would probably just be called a haka, huh?
Well, yeah. I don't know. Differences in languages and whatnot. I don't know.
Touché, yeah. My friend. Well,
I don't think he went that far. I think he was in Hawaii.
Okay. Touchstone Pictures was created by Disney to produce films targeted for a mature audience. What 1984 rom-com was the first film Touchstone produced? This movie's tagline promises from the first laugh, you'll be hooked.
Oh, locked in.
Locked in?
I hope whoever came up with that tagline got a raise.
Locked in. Yeah.
Yeah. Once you get it, it's pretty obvious. Because it's Godfather. From the... Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
I love that movie.
I know you do. But it's not a rom-com. I know you think it is.
It all depends on how you look at it.
No, it really isn't.
Educated guess, something like that.
Which means you got it, right?
Usually.
Yeah.
We know. All right.
And I just remember the theme of the show.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Toy.
Splash.
Andy.
Splash.
Devo.
Splash.
Kells.
Splash.
Yep. It's Splash. Where did that come from?
Hard to say. Misspent youth.
Okay, what film was the first Technicolor picture that director John Huston made? Since Huston preferred to shoot his movies on location, the crew had to contend with leeches and bouts of dysentery while filming, and I have an easy mode.
Locked in.
John Huston.
I'll take the easy mode, please.
He's a director, pals.
Yeah. Easy mode for me, too.
The easy mode is, rumor is that John Huston and Humphrey Bogart did not get sick because they drank liquor and not water while filming.
Damn straight.
I find that really hard to believe.
It's rumors. It's rumored.
Locked in?
I don't know any of his movies, or I don't know I know his movies. Let's see.
You don't know. You
don't know.
Yeah.
You know his
movies. You know his movies.
I know his daughter is. Is it his daughter?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Locked in.
Okay. Debo?
The African Queen?
Uh-uh.
Kels?
Okay. Damn.
The African Queen.
Toy?
African Queen?
Wow.
Andy?
Absolutely the African Queen.
Is the African Queen. Yes.
Good job. Epic boat movie.
Yay! That's how you do it.
Sticking with the theme.
Yeah.
You don't have to show your work on this show. It's
right. Or spell, right? Well,
maybe. Or spell, right?
All right. The Shape of Water was the first sci-fi film to win the Academy Award for Best Picture. Director Guillermo del Toro drew inspiration from what 1954 monster flick when he co-wrote this movie?
Ooh, I got this. I think we had a similar. All right, I'm locking in with the same answer, but I think we've had this before and I screwed up the same way. I'm having deja vu with screw ups, is what I'm having here.
This show says that a lot.
The name of the show.
I listened to this week's published episode, which is a festival of screw ups for me.
We should have had a disclaimer at the beginning of that episode.
You should all get this correct if this was a repeat question, right?
You'd think so.
Yeah, right.
I mean, we've had
we don't learn.
What are we up to? Three, four?
Yeah. I gotta work. He's prepping for sweep the leg four, and it's gonna be bad.
Oh, that's great.
It's gonna be the one with
Neil,
the Russian.
You have permission to use any of my questions.
Oh, thank you.
That's sweet.
Your car. Your car.
Is everybody locked in?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Andy?
I answered Swamp Thing.
Dave-o?
Creature from the Black Lagoon.
Yep. And this has happened before. Yep.
Creature from the Black Lagoon.
There it is.
Toy.
Godzilla.
Hey. This
creature from the Black Lagoon. Yes.
Godzilla.
Grinding Nemo.
And Godzuki. All right. It's the end of.
What? No, I was. Well, one could argue that he is Del Toro's work on Hellboy with Abe Sapien played a big part in that too.
Well, yeah, one could.
Mm-hmm. And I just did. Fight me.
For sure.
Do you have more to add or just
that? I was, you know, wow. A nice rousing dialogue would have been cool, but did I'll you just throw it out there?
Throw that out there.
Throwing it out there. Good job, Devo.
Thank you.
Oh, you're talking about because of the fish guy?
Yes.
Okay.
Fish guy. That's one of the best characters, by the way, in Hellboy.
The Ichthyosapien.
Really? Yeah, I love that character so much.
I've never seen the movie. I've got
it. It's worthwhile. The first one.
Okay, I'm writing it down.
First one's real good. The second one is kind of meh. And the remake is garbage.
I like both of them. I don't like the remake. Yeah.
The remake was garbage.
It is garbage, but the first two are great.
All right. At the end of category five, Twy has 145, Andy 160, Devo 165, Kels 175.
Okay. For the sixth category, this is kind of like my bread and butter. So this category is called Sports, but not. And these are nautical nicknames. So, Twy, I don't know if you've heard my sports, but not. Basically, I don't actually watch any sports, but I come up with sports questions.
Mm-hmm.
So, this That's is a nautical. Awesome. Yeah. It's called This is Nautical Nicknames. All right. Question one. Noodling is a fishing technique where you use a wiggling hand or foot as bait to lure what bottom-dwelling fish? This fish is also the nickname for pitcher Jim Hunter, who helped the Oakland A's win the World Series from 1972 to 1974. What is this fish?
Locked in.
Have you ever noodled before?
Good Lord, no.
No, I'm good.
I have.
You've noodled?
Locked in?
He got a pond.
With these fish in there.
But
your son caught one at my house.
I didn't know what kind of fish he caught.
Oh, yeah.
Did he noodle it?
No.
No.
If I'm right, I don't like this kind of fish.
I'm right. And I know I am. I love this kind of fish.
Oh, me too.
You have it in a pond?
Yeah.
Like, okay. Well, it's let a me hear your fish? Answer first. Okay.
Mahi mahi.
Shark.
I'm thinking like it's a koi fish or something. Okay, Kels.
It's not quite that kind of pond.
Not a fancy pond.
Nope.
Catfish.
Toy.
Catfish.
Andy.
Catfish.
Devo.
Catfish.
It is. Catfish, Jim Catfish Hunter. I guess what I was thinking was like you had like a koi pond.
Oh, no, no. I have koi. More of a fishing and bathing pond.
I don't know what a bathing pond is.
Well, you haven't lived in Arkansas.
You go out back and you take a bath.
With the fish?
With the fish?
With the fish.
Nibble on their toes, can take care of your feet.
he asked the fish to leave while he's bathing.
Yeah.
Could you all just please turn your backs for a minute?
A little privacy.
Getting in.
Oh, I have such a bad picture of you in a pond.
Rest assured, it's not a pond you go swimming in either or bathing. It's a pretty murky, muddy old pond.
Ugh. Okay. All right, I will believe you. Question number two. What rank held by Rebel Commander Jial Akbar is also the nickname of David Robinson, who was a naval submarine officer prior to joining the NBA?
This I'm might be here. Our best sports category ever. I'm like,
yeah, no kidding.
You liked my obscure clue one.
I do. Oh, yeah.
Locked in? Like that one.
That's all time great.
Okay, Twy?
The Admiral.
Andy?
Admiral.
Davo.
Admiral.
Kells.
Admiral.
That is correct.
Why was I think Bettina was concerned that you guys wouldn't get that one, that it was too hard, but I figured all of you would get it from both parts of the clues.
She had me at Star Wars.
Yeah, that's what I asked Neil if I should add that he's from Star Wars.
I got it from David Robinson.
Yeah, I got it from both.
It's funny to think of David Robinson on a submarine, though, isn't it?
He really is, because he's a tall, he's a
large man.
Yeah, I don't think he was in active service on a submarine. I think he was just an officer in the submarine corps.
Yeah.
Okay. Question three. The horrific deaths of Chrissy Watkins and Alex Kinter in 1975 contributed to the increased number of people experiencing galeophobia. Sufferers of this fear may also be leery of Greg Norman, who was given a nickname due to his aggressive golf technique. What is galeophobia a fear of?
Locked in.
Oh.
I didn't know this term, but yeah. I thought it was a fear of that one part of Bohemian Rhapsody.
Fandango. Oh, wait, I know what you mean.
I do have a terrible fear of fandangos, though.
Doing them or just the...
just being around them.
Locked in.
Okay, is everybody locked in?
Yes.
Yeah. All right. Andy.
This is a fear that many of the Jets had as well. Sharks.
Davo?
Sharks.
Kells.
Sharks.
And Twy.
Sharks.
That is correct. And as you know, Chrissy Watkins and Alex Kinter were victims in Jaws.
Mm-hmm.
1975. I think Greg Norman was the great white shark. Yeah. Okay, last one. The doomed ghost ship, The Flying Dutchman, is the subject of an opera by what German composer? It is all the nickname for a legendary pirate's shortstop who shares this composer's surname.
Pirate shortstop.
Locked in.
No, it's not. Really stretch McCovey.
Like first base of movie.
Not just the name, Stretch McCovey. Stretch McCovey.
I'm locked in.
Flying Dutchman.
Locked in.
Okay. Is Davo?
Wagner or Wagner?
Kells.
Wagner.
Oh.
Why?
SpongeBob.
Andy?
Ronnie Mozart Sedano.
Now that <I'm>
I was just had nothing.
Mozart Sedano.
Johannes Wagner and
nice.
Richard Wagner. Yeah.
So at the end of our regular rounds, thanks to corrections from Davo and Kells, our scores are Twy with 175, Andy 190, Davo 200, and Kells 210.
All right.
Anybody's game.
Sudden death.
Shark.
Holy crap.
You gotta warn Dave when you do that. He's sorry.
Man.
The panic is real.
Sorry.
I was getting in the zone and
you're in Arkansas. There is no sharks in your neighborhood.
There's land sharks.
You don't know how deep I roll with the Jets. Come on now.
I'm gonna say this. He lives in a Jets neighborhood, so he's not really worried about sharks.
They dance mostly outside. Two things you don't do.
I can dance if I wanna.
Stop. You can leave your friends behind. You can
stop right now.
Oh my gosh. Okay. So this sudden death is on Captain Fiend.
Captain.
Breaking down one. That better be in here.
Dang it.
Real or is it fictional? Both is a mixture.
It's mixed. Yeah.
Sure, I don't know what you're talking about.
Stop. You don't have to fight them when they do it. You don't have to
fight them. He's the alpha and the omega of ship captains.
All right. He's pushing it, isn't he? Yep.
All right. Good luck, everybody.
Thanks.
Question one.
Thank you.
What superhero was first introduced during World War II, but lost popularity after the war ended? He was reintroduced in the 1960s when the Avengers discovered him trapped in ice.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Feel like it's a trap. Was there
an Aquaman? Was served too, Andy. He just didn't brag about his service.
I flew one, two, three missions.
That's the count from.
Actually, Count Chocula was on the German side, and he came over here with some of their NASA scientists. A lot of people don't know that. Operation Paperclip.
Von Braun.
Yes. Von Braun and Count Chocula.
And Chocula.
Came over at the same time.
I'll take full responsibility for this.
Oh man. Vicosity of marshmallows. His work was.
Please.
Please. I don't know why I find that so funny. It's so dumb.
We're bookending this with the worst cereal jokes in the world.
See, the theory was the astronauts weren't going to splash down, but more of a marshmallow down.
Down.
Yeah. But I'm done. I'm done now.
Yeah. Is this how we keep things on track, Andy?
Yeah. Sorry about that. This is all me.
Okay, Kels. What do we got?
Captain America.
Twy?
Captain America.
Andy.
Captain America.
Devo.
I, too, pledge allegiance to the Captain America flag.
Yeah, you do.
Okay, question two. What iconic swashbuckler did Hugo Award-winning artist Dan Mates illustrate for the Seagram's Company for their best-selling rum?
Locked in.
Jim?
Okay, Twy.
Captain Morgan?
Andy?
Captain Morgan.
Devo?
Captain Morgan.
Kels?
Captain Morgan.
It's Captain Morgan. Good job. All right, question number three. Who sang the song Muskrat Love that hit number four on the Billboard charts in 1976?
Locked in.
Locked in.
76 is a bad year for music, by the way. Bad.
I'm locked in.
All right, Andy.
The Captain and Tennille.
Dave.
The Captain and Tennille.
Do that to me one more. Captain and Tennille.
Why?
Captain Antonio.
It's Captain Antonio.
Dave, I just want to point out that Afternoon Delight came out in 1976.
Yeah, that was the number one song the day I was born.
Nice. Dave, it was a little Afternoon Delight.
Heck yeah, buddy.
I feel like I've been drinking bad wine all night. Yeah.
Question four. What captain of the Pittsburgh Penguins stunned everyone when he made a remarkable comeback on ice only hours after his final radiation treatment for Hodgkin's lymphoma in March of 1993?
Oh, I don't know this.
Penguins?
Locked in. I
don't know this.
Locked in?
I like a little hockey deer.
This is the only penguin from that time frame I can think of.
Well, there's really two, if you're not a hockey fan.
Oh, boy. I hope I picked the right one.
Well, I know he wasn't a penguin. This is the only hockey player I know. Locked in.
Okay, Devo.
Mario Lemieux.
Kels.
Super Mario Lemieux.
Twy?
Lemieux?
Andy.
Captain Bobby Orr?
It's Mario Lemieux.
Oh, he did play for the Penguins. Oh. Captain Bobby
Orr. I had nothing. I'm out.
Andy's out.
Oh, too bad, because I wanted you to answer question five, Andy.
Oh.
Sorry. You know,
if you listen to the show, you'd know I never make it to question five. I mean, you're just toying with me now.
Just some background on this episode. Bettina finished it, I don't know, 6 months ago or something like that. And we were trying to wait for a time when Andy would be playing because she specifically wanted Andy to be around, I think, for this one question.
This one wow. question.
No pressure.
Way to go, Andy.
I didn't make it.
We have company over.
Don't you pile on his new variation of shame? Don't you fall into his shame trap? You're better than this.
Dude.
It's okay. All right, question five.
All right, we'll just move on. That's fine.
This is over.
Wow.
It's okay. It's fine. I'm fine.
Can we collect the Dragon Balls and bring Andy back to life?
We're drinking.
Hopefully, by the time I finish this, I won't remember any of this episode.
This is so funny.
Oh, gosh. Oh.
It's fine.
Yeah, it's fine. Sorry.
Okay. Spell the word captain as it appears on the Captain Crunch cereal box.
Wow. I'm locked in.
I'm locked in.
This is a question where spelling and punctuation matters.
Yeah, I think I have it.
Locked in.
That's the adventure.
That's the adventure.
Andy, do you want to try? Even though you're not part of it,
yeah, I will answer. Thank you for putting a fine point on that. But yeah, I will answer last and see how close I came.
Okay. All right, Devo.
I believe it's CAPN.
Kells.
Capital C A P apostrophe N.
That's why.
C A P apostrophe N.
Andy?
C A P apostrophe N.
Okay, I'll give it to y'all. It's capital C A P apostrophe capital N.
Oh.
Good job.
Oh, I didn't realize.
Since you guys all.
Gotta have a little extra accent on that N.
Captain.
Captain.
The N stands for nom.
Oh, no.
I'm good. I'm good.
It's built up a resistance.
To Iocane power.
I actually put points down for Andy. That was wrong.
And that ain't right.
Oh, Question six. On the series Love Boat, who was the captain of the Pacific Princess, and what was the name of the cruise ship's bartender?
Oh, come on!
What was it?
I get the captain of the Penguins, and now you guys get the Love Boat?
Oh, what was his name?
And there's there's no partial credit in sudden death, so you got to get both parts.
Locked in.
Oh, yes.
All right. Man.
That was loud.
What the heck?
Sorry.
I went into my happy place again.
Do you have this on your Spotify?
No.
Oh, you need to.
It's kind of smooth, but no.
All right, Kels, what is it?
Steubing and Isaac.
Devo?
Steubing and Isaac.
Twy.
Steubing and Isaac.
That is correct. Captain Merrill, Steubing and Isaac. All right, question seven. In a hit Billy Joel song, what is the name of the heroin dealer that promises to get you high and take you to a special
Oh, come on!
In the hit song by who?
Billy Joel.
Okay, I know him.
This is a gimme.
Wow.
I don't think any of Bettina's music questions have been later than 1976 or so.
Yeah, that's where things kind of trail off.
It's all downhill from there.
It's all downhill from there. After 1976, you got Taylor Swift, and I don't know.
Sorry, this song is from 73, so
they don't talk about heroin in Uptown Girl.
Nope. We didn't start the fire.
We didn't sell the heroin. That doesn't work.
Captain's name.
All right, I'm gonna go with this. Because it's what I got in my brain. I'm locked in.
Locked in.
I don't know.
That's a good strategy for trivia. Go with what's in your brain.
Twy, what do you have?
Captain Jack Sparrow.
Oh. Why is the rum gone?
Kels. Luau Cinder.
What?
Wow. Just wow.
Deva.
Captain Trips.
Oh, no,
it's
faster
to stand. I don't know how you're going to score this one.
I mean, I'm tempted to give it to Twy.
Twy? Well, not all of it, but Twy should get half points. I think keeps her in.
Is it Captain Jack or something?
Captain Jack will get you high tonight.
Wow.
Take it to his special island.
I don't know. It's up to you, Bettina.
Oh, me? Of course I'm going to give it to Twy. Let's go.
What?
Thank you.
Wow. Yeah. Well, good on you, Twy.
You're barely faking.
Oh. Here comes the saltiness and the swearing.
Well, good on you, Twy. Always rooting for you. Wow.
So proud of you.
Twy, have you gotten your blood pressure checked? Because you might need to before you go on the next episode.
Yeah. Oh, gosh.
And so, no pressure, but Twy, if you get these last three questions, you will win the game.
Really, Neil?
And you'll make Devo explode.
Okay.
You only need to get two to beat Devo, though. You passed Andy a long time ago.
Oh, yeah, I'm in last.
But you guys all got over the Allison line, right?
Oh, yeah.
We're all over 200 by this time.
Oh, yeah. So, all right. That's the Twy line is 200?
It's the Twy line.
Ooh, the Twy line.
I like the sound of it, though.
I do like the sound of
it. It's kind of nice.
All right. Okay, Twy, let's go. On the TV show The A-Team, which one of the four main characters had been a captain in the Army?
Oh, God. Oh, my God.
I'm call me Twy.
Sure, but I got a decent guess.
Hannibal?
Is that your answer?
Yes.
I'm sorry. It's Captain H.M. Murdoch. He was an army pilot captain.
Oh, right.
Hannibal was a colonel.
Colonel.
Oh. Oh, I would have fallen for that, too.
Wait, Murdoch was the crazy one, right?
Mm-hmm.
But was he really crazy or was he acting?
He was a little crazy.
He was a little bonkers.
At some point, it doesn't matter.
Okay.
But yeah.
Okay, so...
Good job.
So I'm not into military stuff at all, but if someone were a colonel, wouldn't they have been a captain at some point?
Yes. Yes, oh, that is true. Is she still in it? She is still in it.
All right. Good job, Troy. Because I didn't fly.
Dave was livid right now.
Look at all the loopholes. Come on.
Wow.
Number nine. Come on.
That's, it's cool. Sure. We'll do that.
All right. In 2004, Britton Keyshan became the youngest person to climb each of the seven summits. On Mount Everest, he placed a photo of his famous grandfather, an actor noted for playing what TV character?
Oh, I think I know what it is.
Captain Kangaroo?
That is correct!
Are you kidding me right now?
That's what I was, yeah.
And Captain Kangaroo's real name was Bob Keeshan. That was his grandfather. Good job, Dwight!
Wow!
You're doing great. Last question. Okay. Wait, if you get this question wrong, then you're tied?
No.
Oh,
no. She'll be in second place.
Kel's already won.
No. If you get this one right, you'll be Kel's.
Oh, okay.
Wait a minute.
So Kel's has 270 right now. Twy has 265.
So win by five.
All right. What was the name of the pirate who operated the ship SS Filet-O-Fish that appeared in McDonald ads from 1971 to 1985.
Wow. So
was the Filet-O-Fish actually a steamship?
I don't know.
It's a fried ship.
I have no idea what this is.
It's got to be something stupid because it's McDonald's.
There goes that sponsorship.
That is true.
I don't know. I don't even have a guess for this.
I don't even have a guess either. Captain McDonald. I don't know.
Solid.
I don't have a guess either. I don't remember this character at all.
Mm-mm. It's Burger King, isn't it? It's the King.
like the Spanish and the British, the Burger King is getting other people's ships. Pillage McDonald's.
So I think they were trying to make a play with Captain Cook, and it's Captain Crook is the name of it. Captain Crook. Oh my gosh, that was so much fun. What are the scores, Neil?
Well, the scores are Andy had ended up with 220 points, Devo 260,
what?
Twy 265, and Kel's 270.
Devo is... Good job, Kels.
Thank you.
Well done, Kels.
Congrats, thank Kels.
You. Great game, job, Kels. Yeah. Good game, buddy. Now hear the way you dance through the salt of dog leg.
Watching and got two answers right.
No.
No,
it's fine. It's fine.
So believable.
Games aren't dictated by rules anyway. It's just what feels right. You know? Wow. Just go with it.
Even on the podcast, you can feel that vein throbbing in his forehead.
Could you hear it?
It's who we're rooting for more than the actual structure that we present. Wow. On the whole. You know, that's all. That's all. Good job, Kels.
Thanks, buddy.
I was rooting for you, Devo. Good job, Devo.
Thanks. I was doing really well there for a little while. Felt good about my chances. Yeah, this was a great game. Everybody got over 200. That's a sign of a good game. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we had fun. And that's what matters. So.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. We all had a fighting chance right to the end there until the rules went out the window. And then it was a free for all, you know. Whatever happens, happens, you know. That's all good. You know, it's not a big deal. What was this? No.
No, I'm fighting this way out of you.
He is cracking.
He is cracking. It's all fine.
I can't wait to see this. He acts like Twy brought in a folding chair.
Well, kind of did, you know. It's all right, you know. That's good. It doesn't show up on the annual. Neil compiles all the stats. This is going to be a third place for me and a second place for Fly, even though it was stolen from me by nefarious means. You know, no big deal. No big deal. No big deal. I'm good. So, from all of us here at the Brain Ladle Trivia Podcast, I am your MC Davo with Kells.
Soon we'll be making another run.
Twy.
Toodles.
Andy.
So long, ladle brainers.
Bettina.
Oh, thanks for having me. I hope I get invited back. I'm sorry, Davo, for your
Of course you'll be invited back. You'll be invited back. We'll just have to, you know, refresh the rules at the beginning of the game. But that's okay. That's all right. And the sensei Neil.
Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a faithful trip that started from this tropic point aboard this tiny ship. The mate was a mighty sailor man, skipper brave and sure. Five passengers set sail that day for a three-hour tour.
Storm.
Oh, I love the piccolo. I love the piccolo in that song.
That's a good piccolo. It's
pretty solid. It's a piccolo.
Signing off.
Solid.
That was a great show, guys.
Good show.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bettina.
Hi, I think this question's going to take a lot more thinking. I'm Brain Ladle's Andy McBride. Do you like wholesome trivia? Sure, we all do. But you know, here at Brain Ladle Productions, those bleeps aren't free. And Davo's stewing over there just now. You know, for the price of a cup of coffee, you can join Patreon and help support Bleeping Davo. With your support, we can make sure Davo continues to swear, and he'll be able to swear like a carny hobo that just found out that that rich bachelor found somebody else.
Oh, underoos.
Andy, you. Somebody.
I'm Brain Ladle Andy McBride. Thanks again for listening.
And now back to the show. The way he's
That's how we all became. We became friends in the basement because we found out, wow, we can make each other laugh with the stupidest shit. Everybody else just looks at us funny and we would just burst out laughing.
Just crack up.
That's where you keep all the, you know, chemicals in the basement, right?
Lots.
In Andy's closet.
Yeah. I had a closet full of chemicals, and Davo made sure there was no fresh air or sunshine, and it all worked.
You painted the windows.
There were no windows. You were underground.
There was literally the closest window. The closest window was a long tunnel.
It really was
a very long tunnel.
And where?
You could see daylight.
To a loading dock.
To Davo's famous loading dock.
To my loading dock.
Davo's loading dock. Get that shit off of my loading dock.
Get that shit off my dock.
I'm so confused.
That's You know, it's a wonder anybody listens to us, to be honest.
I mean, is it?
Again, magic of editing.
I'm like, because a lot of this stuff doesn't make it.
Never makes it.
That's like a perk to being married to a guy from Switzerland. Stefan will just randomly sing David Hasselhoff songs.
Perk?
David Hasselhoff?
Question mark?
How many songs does he have?
Freedom, talking about, yeah.
Wow.
The freedom.
I,
this is fantastic.
I got nothing over here.
Okay.
Y'all still hear that?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, it's Twy.
It's hovering. It's
Twy, is there a UFO?
Oh, is airplane going by?
No, no, I think it's going. Do you have like a fan going, or
it sounds kind of like a fan?
Is your husband using a router?
Oh my gosh!
No.
He might be doing some woodworking in the living room. I don't know. Building is a Viking longboat, dear.
The Drakkar won't build itself.
All right, well, we'll have to figure it out later. We'll have to work with it. It's already been on tape for a while, so it's nothing we're going to fix.
On tape, you're adorable.
Unless it's my neighbor's AC.
Could you go over and ask him to turn it off?
Yeah.
Real quick. Text her.
We have a very important podcast with tens of listeners.
Dozens.
A cinematographer. I'll do it again. All right. Hold on. Hold on 1 second.
Oh, there we go.
Okay. All right. Got it.
We're taking sips right out of the box.
Oh. Turn the box up.
It does have a spout.
Ringing that box out there at the top.
Just like a juice box for adults.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm drinking.
Oh. I got it.
That's
got
to stay. I don't care how it makes it look.
Yeah,
stay.
just chomp. How about you?
And that was, I almost thought that was Allison there for a second.
I'm drinking.
That was Allison-esque for sure.
The preceding podcast was presented by Brain Ladle Productions. All rights reserved.
Sure, come get this baby.